随着美国商务部公布四月新屋销售比起三月份大幅减少16.6%，且经季节调整后只有约59.1万户，数据不止创下9年来最大降幅，且成交户数也创下2年来新低。无独有偶，美国房地产知名指标之一 MSCI Real Assets 也公布，四月份商用不动产销售额只有394亿美元，比起去年同期下滑16%，不止相较于三月份的激增57%，几乎呈现发夹弯逆转，同时也等于宣告了连续13个月的成长正式被打断。面对这两波警讯，一些经济学家分析主要反映出包含饭店、办公大楼、银发族住宅以及工业用不动产出现销售大跌，同时也象征着这波涨幅背后的动能可能正在衰退中。不过，知名华人企业乔福地产总裁 Peter Kam 却发现，美国华人区的房地产几乎不受影响，甚至还出现逆向喷发。
Not in California, we believe or not, California is still very, very strong, and the price was stubbornly high up there. Right now, the price is standing at $830,000 for an average home in California. That is like.And another 10% increase compared to last year, and it's continuing to go upward, and they were predicted by the end of 2023 it will be $870,000. So as a matter of fact, there over 50% of the deals were consummated in higher than the asking price. For example, if your asking price is $1 million.The buyer usually have to pay $1.1 million or $1.2 million in order to get a house. That's ridiculous, you know, and that's why a lot of buyers are discouraged. And from the end of last year, they don't even want to be competing in the market. So they lost a lot of buyer.
正因为加州房市的交易热潮仍处于高位，不止推升房价，从2021年至今始终维持涨势，让买家压力倍增。加上房地美五月底公布，美国30年期固定利率抵押贷款的平均水平正式突破5%，不止攀升到11年来新高，且从年初至今也已回升超过2个百分点，也让不少买家开始转向观望，期待是否可以在2022年下半年等到一段需求下滑与房价回跌。然而，乔福地产总裁 Peter Kam 却提醒，在华人区房源供不应求的大趋势下，华人买家理想中期待的房价回跌至少10%，恐怕都有困难。
When you have a listing, the buyers that you have multiple buyers, you have 20, 30 buyers competing with one property. And that's why the price is stubbornly high. And people think that because of the Federal Reserve hike up the interest rate, it will slow down the price considerably.That's not the case. And don't expect that the price to drop anytime soon. You know, as a matter of fact, it will even by the end of the year, it will be even more. So, it's luckily that now the listing, more listing in the market now. So the buyer has a better chance to compete. So they are more gradually coming back to the market or coming back to the table and negotiate the price. But still, because of the lack of inventory, the price is still up there.
更让许多华人买家捉摸不透的是，明明来自美国知名房地产经纪商 REFI 的统计，五月份的美国房市有20%卖家降低售价，且买家需求也在大量减少，并且都是近2年来的最大跌幅。但是为什么反观华人居住密集城市，几乎看不到类似情况？一些地产专家分析，主要原因是多数美国人仍将房地产视为最佳的长期投资。因为根据盖洛普民调，高达45%的受访人赞成房地产是最好的长期投资，且相较于股票，赞成的民调数只有24%。 而乔福地产总裁 Peter Kim 则以当前华人区普遍的房地产交易情况更深入的说明影响因素。
Over 40% of the deals are all cash. That means they don't need to get any loans.
Even this year?
Yeah, even up to now. Up to now, there's like 40% of the deals are all cash.Because they are so eager to get to buy the property, because of the inflation. You know that now the inflation is you're looking at inflation. Officially, it's only 8.3%, but in reality, it's much more than that. It's more likely to be in the range of 14-15%. Because where can you put the money? You know, right now.The economy is not so stable, and when you do an investment like opening a restaurant or doing other business investment, it's pretty risky, right? And the stocks are overpriced, you know, it's a lot of times it will fall back down again. So the only real thing is real estate. Like last year, the property increased 22%.Where can you get that kind of appreciation, right?
此外，华人房屋买家如何选择最合适的投资房，同时避免新冠疫情期间从电话到网络各种层出不穷、令人防不胜防的诈骗案件，例如提供让人不可置信的低价房源，或谎称可以借出更好的信用分数等。乔福地产总裁 Peter Kim 也不忘提醒华人，应该选择有执照、合格的地产经纪，并且对各种签约流程与法律文件也要提高警觉，避免吃亏上当。
You have to be careful, you know, you cannot be overly do it, and because there's a lot of regulations in the real estate, you know, discrimination for one thing, you know, you cannot.Impress the seller and say that hey, I'm a Chinese, you know, you are Chinese, so you should do me some favoritism and sell me the property. That is not allowable. Okay, so you have to be careful too. But the things that you can do to impress the seller is that hey, you know, if you don't want to do too much inspection. In other words, you will accept the house so as is, and also it's all cash deal. Say if you have all cash, you don't need to get a loan. It's much easier to close escrow.
且值得注意的是，五月份的房价中位数已经飙升到44.7万美元。不止比起2021年增长17.6%，且与2020年同期相比，更增加了35.4%。也就是说，在价格仍以两位数增长的情况下，真的很难等到房价下跌。且相对利率将持续上涨的趋势下，建议可以考虑先与时间赛跑，找好专业的地产经纪，趁早买房。
We have a lot of resources to help the client to do a good CMA, which is the market analysis, and to see how much is your property's worth. We have a lot of resources that can do accurate market analysis and to determine the real value of the property. And our agents are well trained. They know most of the disclosure. A lot of disclosure are very important in real estate. And you don't want to make a mistake. If you make mistake, the buyer is not happy, the seller are not happy. And so we minimize that kind of trouble for our clients.
提醒观众，在华人居住密集区，相对适合亚洲新移民的成熟生活圈、文化配套以及众多住商混合开发案的帮助下，只会吸引更多来自香港和台湾买家。因受到亚洲政治环境的影响，持续考虑转汇资金进入美国买房，两者相辅相成之下，不止力抗华人区的房价下跌，同时也导致好房源持续维持在多人竞价的局面。宝富银行财经最前线系列专题，下一集将继续邀请到各领域专家，为观众分析更多产业新资讯，欢迎观众持续锁定。东森新闻团队洛杉矶报道。